You have found your voice in a way through a tragedy. I mean, you, the mother of Trayvon Martin, the mother of Michael Brown, people who have gone through such terrible experiences who are now becoming activists and putting themselves out there. I just want to ask you, how did you find the strength to kind of step into the public eye after going through what you did with the loss of your father?
Well, after all those news articles, because it's a thing called respectability politics. So when something happened where an officer kills one of our people, the first thing that comes out is their criminal record. They further victimize our loved ones that's dead, and then that victimizes further us dealing with it. So, you know, this whole rhetoric of my father selling cigarettes, that wasn't true. It was made up by PBA president to try to justify why they murdered him. And that is so wrong. And I just felt like, you know, my father's not here to defend himself. I'm his oldest child. He raised me to be outspoken and a leader. And that's exactly what I wanted to be. I didn't know that I was going to, you know, rock the whole nation, but I was just speaking from the heart. I miss my dad, and this is what I can do for my dad.
And I'm sure that he will be proud to see your efforts today and the fact that you haven't backed down. You know, we know that there wasn't an indictment by that New York State grand jury, but there are reports that a federal grand jury is hearing the case in terms of what happened to your dad. Are you hopeful for any further justice beyond the settlement that your family received? Are you hopeful that something else can come out of this to make the situation as right as it could be?
Honestly, to tell you, I lost hope a long time ago. I'm not jumping up and down. It's been almost 2 years, and now they starting to do the federal grand jury. Although I do appreciate Loretta's Lynch. Like moving forward with it and saying that she presenting charges or whatever, but I just want it to happen swiftly. I don't want them to drag their feet, and I still want to hold them, put pressure on them, because 2.5 years, no answer, and the killer cops are still on payroll, and they trying to use a scapegoat, a Sergeant Adonis, Kizzy Adonis, a black woman who didn't have nothing to do with the crew that jumped on my father's back and decided to kill him. They wanna put her for failure to supervise. And I wrote an article about that. And I feel like failure to supervise goes all the way to the top, all the way from the borough commander all the way up to Bill de Blasio, because they all failed us that day on that fateful day, July 17th.
So you are continuing to fight for justice now for your father in a different way through encouraging people to be involved politically. Is there any final message that you want to give people as we go into election 2016 about why black lives should matter?
It's keep happening to us. They don't get it. It's nothing put in place. They want to talk about these body cameras, but there's no federal policy that's if you tamper with this videotape that you're going to jail. They just killing us and getting away with it. And then Naya McKinney got flung across the classroom by a police officer. We need to get out those police officers out of our schools for our kids. We need to protect our kids, because our kids is no longer safe on the streets or in school. So please, your vote matters, and please look up and pay attention to Bernie Sanders. He is the right candidate. He is not, I believe that he is not going to fail us. He's not going to go into the White House and turn his back like somebody else I know.
Well, Erica, we really appreciate your time today. We wish you all the luck, and we thank you so much for your activism and for speaking out and sharing your voice.
Thank you.
And thank you for watching thegrio.com. Stay tuned and stick with us for news that matters.